speed.
3, 2.
So I ended up with these two cars because I bought it from a guy that had a collection of 10 cars, and I wanted two or three cars out of the collection, and these came with them. Interestingly enough, they're fairly significant parts. The one here on my left is a Banjo Matthews car made by Banjo Performance in Arden, North Carolina. And it's the last of the Pontiac, it's the 1986 Pontiac Grand Prix. And it's, they call it the high snout, or bubble back road course car. And Rusty Wallace was the driver. And he, quite honestly, did fairly well with the car. Drove it in 1986, and then won a race at Watkins Glen in 1987, and also at Riverside International Speedway on the road courses. And turned around the following year and won another race at Riverside International Raceway, and won the, I think they call it the Winston All-Star race at Charlotte Speedway. He won that one also in this car. I'm thrilled to have it because of the history and, you know, Rusty Wallace. I mean, one of the better stock car drivers in his day. And I can't wait to take it out and run it on track. It's set up for road courses, as I alluded to, because it's where it had its success. And for those of you who don't know, if you can't take the same stock car that you take to an oval track and run it on a road course, it doesn't work. And on my right is a 1998 Chevrolet Monte Carlo. This was built by Hess Racing for a fellow by the name of Buzz McGaugh, Buzz McCall. And it was driven by a Californian and somebody that most everybody knows, Robbie Gordon, of open wheel racing fame, off road racing, and ran for most of the 1998 season in the Winston Cup Series. Didn't have a lot of success. Again, it's a road course car. Ron Fellows drove this car one time at Watkins Glen, if I'm not mistaken, and did fairly well with it. Sat it on the pole, but the car broke during the race. And then later on, Robbie Gordon drove it at Sears Point. And again, the car broke during the race. But I'm thrilled by the fact that both of these are road course cars, which is where I like to drive them. And I haven't had a chance yet to drive either one of them, but I'm looking forward to that day. And because of the sponsorship and who built the car, I'm glad to have both this one and the Rusty Wallace car in my collection.
And cut.